What can go wrong with dermal fillers? Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Not everything is perfect with dermal fillers. Let's see what can go wrong. Okay, so it's all the craze. Everyone's getting fillers. Thousands are done every day in this country. A lot of Instagram, social media shows all the glory and the beautiful results and the best before and afters that exist. It's not all that way, and things can go wrong. I'm gonna go through four not so bad things, and then I'm gonna go through, at the end of the video, four bad things. So let's start with the not so bad. Number one, redness, swelling, bruising, a bit of irritation. Those are all things you should pretty much expect. Number two, and this you might think is a good thing, but it can be something not so good either. Number two is they ended up liking it. So what happens is they want more. And when they want more, sometimes they want more and more. When you get these products, people get attention, whether it's lip filler or a high cheek or rejuvenation or glow. It creates attention and people can like it to the point where they get too much done. The next one is, number three, it doesn't last. For a lot of people, not lasting is certainly not enough doing enough product. It's also getting used to the product that they've had, because when people think of a result in their mind, they have an idea that they're trying to convey to the provider. And that congruency is really important, that they understand each other. But a lot of times they might think it just doesn't last long enough for what they spent. So longevity ends up being a problem of the fillers. Number four, they just don't like it. They don't like the result. They don't like having this product in their face. They don't like the feel. They don't like the reaction from other people. So there's a lot of emotion involved in these treatments. It's emotionally charged and you're changing the way you look. It's not something you hide. It's not a body part. It's not losing weight. It's not breast or buttock implants. It's something that everyone sees every day, no matter what. You can't hide it or mask it. So let's go to the not so good problems. The first one is, we all dread vascular occlusion, and that's by putting product in or swelling around a vessel. I believe it can happen both ways. The latter is a little controversial, but I really believe it happens. 70 to 90% of providers would think that you can get an external compression as well. Some don't. Either way, stopping blood flow to an area is never good. It's the same thing for a stroke. It's the same thing for a heart attack, lack of blood supply. Same thing can happen in the face, and you can lose a part of the tissue. I did a video on vascular occlusion, a whole video on it, and I'll post a link in the description below so you can watch that video for a more complete scenario of what that looks like and what it is. Number two, delayed onset nodules. Now, this is a very big topic. You could do a 20-minute discussion and that still wouldn't be enough, but essentially, the product's in there, everything's going great, and then for one of many reasons, at 1 month to 8 months is typical, all of a sudden the filler swells and the body reacts to it. And no one knows the exact etiology. This is debated. That's why a lot of times people like dissolvable fillers, because it gives you one avenue of getting rid of that problem. It's not the total answer, because it can take a little bit more than just dissolving, but delayed onset nodules where the filler and the body react after it's in place. Number three would be granuloma, seen especially with longer term products. It's when the body just says, I don't like it, and attacks it. And it's one of the reasons that things like calcium hydroxylapatite, Sculptra, or Bellafill, the longest term products on the market, the latter two, are 50 microns or less in size. And that's kind of the magic number. Particle sizes that are larger than 50 microns, the body wants to get rid of it. Imagine if you have a step on a needle or a wood splinter, you get a wood splinter, what does the body do? It has to extract it and get rid of it. It can do that to fillers, and that's called a granuloma. That's different from delayed onset nodules, but it's something that happens and it has a whole treatment regimen, and it's not good when it happens. We don't like that. The fourth one is nodules. Now, I'm not talking about just like a lip filler nodule that came up. You can dissolve that and get rid of it. I'm talking about clumping of product, such as PLLA, such as PMMA, and sometimes you get it with hyaluronic acid products where the product just sticks together and forms a nodule, lump, or bump. This is more easily treated than the first three problems, but people sometimes don't like to feel a lump, bump, or irregular area, even though they might not see it, they might feel it. And a lot of times we just let that be. So a nodule would be different. And also with a nodule, there's no inflammatory reaction. The body's not attacking a nodule, it's simply too much product in one area. So I hope that helps. There's things that can go wrong with fillers. It's not all the glory that it seems to be on social media and in Instagram and even here on YouTube. The whole thing is a process, and it's getting to know your provider. It's working with them over time to create the look that's best for you, that's gradual and natural, hopefully. So thanks for joining me. Pop over to Instagram. We have great discussions over there. Stay tuned. Subscribe to this YouTube channel. Let us know your thoughts below in the comments section. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, vibrant.